You do realize you don't have to do all of this yourself, right? Over the last several months, we've been talking about how to do a lot of these interactions with VR, how to make hands work, how to pick up things, how to do movement, all that kind of stuff. But you do realize that there are some frameworks on the Unity Asset Store that do all of this for us, right? Now, I've always been a bit of a purist, and I like to know how things work and how the code works and all that kind of stuff, but I thought it would be helpful to show you guys, especially the ones of you who are not self-proclaimed coding enthusiasts and more lean towards the art side, if you want to just get a VR project up and running quick, the five assets that I'm going to talk about in this video are going to be your best bet for getting a VR project up and running quickly and relatively pain-free. Welcome back. If you're new here, my name's Justin P. Barnett, and I do virtual reality tutorials, and I actually am going to start doing some devlogs here in a little bit to show you guys the process of making a VR game from start to finish and releasing it on Steam. So I'd like to document that process, show you guys what all the steps are and how to do it, and I'm not even going to write all the code for all of it. I'm going to use one of these frameworks that we're about to talk about. So let's jump into it. The first one, and a free one I might add, is VRTK, Virtual Reality Toolkit. And before I get too into this asset, just know that right now, as of the version 3.3 that it's on currently, it does not work with Unity's new virtual reality updates as of 2019.3 and above. They are working on a version 4 that they're about to release in the near future, so stay tuned for that. But as of this video, it does not work yet. But just keep this on your radar. They're going to update it soon, and version 4 is going to come out and fix all the bugs that are in it currently. But to start out with, this is a great virtual reality toolkit. Hence the name. It's a framework that you can just drag and drop into your project, and you have all of these kinds of interactions, from climbing to two-handed grabs to using guns, to resizing objects, to having snap zones for objects, pointer interactions, haptic feedback, highlighting objects. You have doors, levers, buttons, drawers, knobs, a panel menu, radio menus, UI elements, lots of things inside of this pack, all for free. So once they get this updated, I highly recommend adding this to your Unity library. The next one on my list, number 4, is Hurricane VR. And this one is also a virtual reality framework, so you could use this as an entirety for your project. This one is a little more oriented towards interactions. And yes, you'll see the price is $59.99. The rest of these packs that I'm going to talk about are going to be paid, but I think that they are well worth the price, especially if you're going to release your game and make that much and more back from your launch. Highly recommend just biting the bullet, paying for one of these assets, and, you know, saving hours of your life in game development. This one is similar to VRTK, but the interactions are more fine-tuned. You have a lot more control over the interactions. You have physics-based bows and arrows. You have finger tracking with the Valve knuckle controllers. It integrates well with the Final IK asset, so you can add a fully inverse kinematic body to this VR rig. You have a stabbing system with the spears. You can stab through things. You have, you know, locomotion, which you would normally expect. They have the gravity gloves from Half-Life Alyx that you can use to grab objects from a distance. You also have dynamic poses, so you can set hand poses for grabbing things. You have basic gun physics and all of the gun interactions that you would need for a FPS game. All the guns have recoil and physics and that kind of stuff. And then you have doors, drawers, all the other stuff you would get in VRTK as well. Also, there's holsters, so this is a one complete package that you can use to set up everything. You just download this package and you have all of these assets and interactions available to you to just start drag and dropping into a game to get up and running quick. We're all about prototyping and getting games out fast, trying to prototype fast, fail fast. The goal is to test out game ideas, see if they're fun. If they are fun, try to riff on it, try to make it a little better, turn it into a game, see what we can do with that mechanic that's fun, and try to make it into a whole game that we can release. If it's not fun, or not as fun as we would like to imagine, then the speed at which we were able to develop that with, we didn't waste a lot of time. We spent maybe a week or two developing some very specific mechanics to see if our specific idea was good, and if not, we can go on to a new
project.
Number three on my list is Hexabody. And Hexabody is less of a framework and more of a player controller, as it says in the name, Hexabody VR Player Controller. So when you use this asset, you get the walk feature, run feature, crouch feature. But I especially like the being able to do physics-based climbing with this asset. This asset nails physics-based climbing and being able to pull up on things and have your character throw off of it. That's very hard to do and very physics-based, and this asset nails that. And so if you need walking, running, jumping, crouching, climbing, it has ramps. So if you don't want your player to go up a specific height of incline, it even has air acceleration. Like, this is a very good asset for player controller. So less of a framework, because a lot of the interactions aren't necessarily there, but being able to move around and that kind of stuff, Hexabody VR Player Controller really nails that. This next one is a little bit lower in price. It's $39.99 and it's Autohand. And oh my goodness, this one is amazing. So if you're looking for realistic hand movement, I highly recommend Autohand. It has the most realistic procedural grip. It has the best feeling hands that you can, that was weird to say, but the hands, it's just when you're in the game, they feel like they're your hands. And you have this little subtle finger sway when they're moving around. Also, it's fully physics based, so anything you pick up will have the appropriate forces applied to it. So if you pick up something heavy, your hand will slide off of it or break, and sometimes you need two hands to pick up stuff. All of that calculation and integration is a part of this asset. It's really nice. There's, you know, buttons, levers, doors, all that kind of stuff. But also, you know, the main appeal of this asset is the procedural fingers. So anything you grab, it will automatically track where the fingers need to go on that object when you pick it up. And that is so cool and so nice. In the next year or two, this is going to be the standard for any VR game going forward, because this is the way that VR games are supposed to be made. So if you want realistic hands, there aren't any inverse kinematics yet, and climbing is not a part of this asset yet, but the developer is working on them. They're in development. You can check out the developer's Trello board if you like and see where things are in the process. But once inverse kinematics and climbing get into this asset pack, this is by far going to be my favorite. Also, the documentation and getting set up with Autohand is so nice. It's super easy to do. It walks you through it, and it's pretty simple to get going with Autohand. So the developer and the Discord are very nice. And the last but not least, my favorite number one on the list is VR Interaction Framework. This is a full framework setup, $59.99 US dollars. Highly, highly recommend getting this asset pack. You have full gun integration, you have a inventory system, you have UI system, you have a climbing system, you have physics-based hands, they have the gravity gloves, bow and arrow assets, two-handed weapons, you have a damage system, destructible objects, inverse kinematics, markers, whiteboards, grappling hooks, you can slow down time, jetpacks. This this framework has anything that you could ever want to do in virtual reality. It's absolutely incredible. And the latest update added vehicles and RC cars. It's ridiculous. And if you have the Final IK asset, this integrates perfectly with Final IK. So you can have a full inverse kinematic body. There's less of an emphasis on physics here than the Autohand asset. And that's why I pointed out Autohand, because I love the physics and I think that's where VR is going. I mean, there are physics and you can add all that kind of stuff. But if you just want to get a game up and running, this is the asset for you. This is the asset that I'm going to use when I start doing my devlogs, when I start developing my first game. I'm going to start out with this, and we're going to go from there. There we go. My five favorite Unity VR assets. Now, these are all focused on more of a framework kind of asset. There are a few of them were a little more niche in a certain direction, like the character controller or Autohand. But if you want to get up and running with a VR project, I highly recommend using any of these five. They work amazing. Links to all of them are down in the description if you're interested in checking any of them out. The links are affiliate links, so they help me out. They help me make more videos, so I really appreciate that. And definitely join the Discord if you're not already. We have a great community, and it's super helpful if you're trying to debug something. You can throw a debugging question in one of our channels or just hang out, show off your work, any of that kind of stuff. It's a great community. I think we're going to be running a game jam here in a little bit, so join in for that. that. That's going to be fun. VR specific game jam. Stay tuned for more details about that. And as always, I reply to every single comment on every single one of my videos. So if you have a question or a comment, just put it down in the comment and I'll mix it up down there with y'all until next week.